Why, hello, one and all. My name is Awesome, and I am one of the mappers in the Battlegrounds 2 development team, and that means I make maps. And today, I thought I would show you guys a little behind the scenes. So what I'm going to do today is edit the map Line Battle, Battle of Concord. So we're going to edit that Line Battle map, but before we do that, I think it would be proper to actually take a look at how the map is right now. Alright, here we are, loading the map up. And what's gonna happen? What's it gonna look like? Oh, it crashes. Okay, that is nowhere near what we want to be. So first we're gonna have to fix this crashing problem. Now, fortunately, I know exactly what is causing this problem. Now we can go back to Hammer. This is our map editing program. So we're gonna go to Open. Alright, now we're going to find our map. Here we go. Alrighty. Look at the map. Now, this is not how the map actually looks in-game. I mean, we don't have our graphical effects, but when we're just editing it, we don't really care about graphical effects. So, first I'm going to change the name of this map, because when we decompiled it, it gave it a name that we don't want. So, Line Battle, Battle of Concord. There we go. Alrighty, there we go. Now we have it under our name. Now the first thing we're going to do is fix that crashing bug. Now the problem, the thing that's causing the crashing, I know, is the terrain. We're going to have to modify the terrain. So first we're going to find out which texture this terrain is using. Ground slash fresh, flash, grass, dirt. So now I'm going to go into my folders here and we're going to find that file. Materials. It was in ground, flash, grass, dirt. Was that it? Alright, I'm going to open this terrain. Nope. The problem with the texture that we're going to have to fix is the detail type. Now, the detail type determines what the grass sprites that you see pop up. The 3D sprites that actually stick out from the two-dimensional texture. So I'm going to change the detail type to grass basic, which I already made, so we can just plug that in. Alrighty, we'll save it. And now we should be able to compile. So I'm going to try to compile it. Yeah, it looks glitched up now in Hammer, but I'm going to compile it. And now we're going to see if it works. Alright, now I'm going to load the map back up again. Alrighty, now when we looked at that map, it was completely screwed up. The lighting, well, there wasn't any lighting. So we're going to have to find out what is wrong with the lighting. So the way I'm going to do that is hide everything in the map except for point entities. Now, point entities are your lights. Those are your props, etc. So I'm just going to disable the light, basically seeing everything except for what I want to see. So now I'm looking for the light environment, and here we go, I found it. Alrighty, let's turn everything back on. Now we're gonna open up this little guy and see exactly what the problem is. Alright, well, we're going to disable HDR, or for the next time we compile. Let's see if that changes anything, because I don't see anything here that should be screwing up the lighting. Okay, so when we disabled HDR, it looked fine. So there's a problem with the HDR. Let's take a second look. And this here light entity. Ah, there it is. See that? The brightness for the HDR lighting is like 1. Now, a brightness of 1 is not a lot. Not at all. A lot at all. So, I'm going to change these values to match the normal ones. Alrighty, so that should fix the HDR lighting. But for now, we're not going to be using HDR because that just adds compile time that we don't really even want. Alrighty, so now the first thing. So we have our grass sprites. That's always nice. Now that the map isn't crashing either because those sprites look pretty good. So what we're going to do now is we're going to actually change the grass texture itself, the two-dimensional flat texture. So we're going to go back to this here texture. Let's find it. Alrighty. Is this it? Yep, that's it. We're going to export this to somewhere or to a format that we can open. Let's find the folder here. Export it. Alright, now let's find it. Now we're going to open it. Alrighty, now I'm in GIMP, which is what I use to edit all these images. So first, I'm going to scale this piece of texture up. Let's just make it 1024 by 1024. That means it has a lot more pixel information, and in the end will look a whole lot higher quality. But just scaling a texture up does not improve its quality, because still everything's going to look the same pretty much no matter how much you scale it up. So you have to add stuff to it to make it look better. So the way we're going to do that is we're going to paste another grass texture on top of this. So I'm going to open another texture as a layer. See if I can find it. Alrighty, here we go. Now this texture here that I put on top is actually too big. So I'm just going to scale it down. Alrighty. Now, which of these textures look higher res? Well, this one looks higher res, but we still want to keep the overall feeling and the overall tone of this texture. So what we're going to do here is make the mode of the layer, we're going to change it to value. Okay, now we're going to make this, and we're going to lower its resolution, its opacity some. So we're going to override it. Now we're going to go back here, and we're going to import it. Alright, now we have our image here. I'm going to save it. Now, someone tells me that in-game this is just going to look like crap. But we're going to try it anyways. Alright, wonder how this is going to look? Guess we'll find out, eh? Not too bad, not too bad. It probably could definitely be better. I think it's a good start. No, another problem too is that texture resolution of the actual texture in the world, we can scale that down and make it look slightly higher res. We could try that. Alright, yeah, let's go ahead and try that. So it's gonna look a whole lot sharper. First, I gotta actually restart Hammer. Yeah. So that the texture will actually look normal. Alrighty, let's open this back up. Alrighty, now I'm gonna have to select all of these displacements, which is really gonna suck. So I'm just gonna time lapse through this thing. Alrighty, now I've all of them selected. Now I'm gonna group them together. So now I can just deselect and then select all of them again all at once rather than having to select all of them again. Okay, I'm gonna set the texture resolution here to let's try 0.2. And I'll do the same here. Ah, that's too low because then you can see it tiles, and then it looks bad when it tiles. So you can either choose high resolution or tile. And there you just heard my mic really screw up. So right now I'm doing post commentary and fast forwarding most of this because the mic quality was crap And if I did the whole video as I originally intended, it would take probably would have taken something like an hour. So I'm speeding this up. And right now what I'm doing is I'm doing the first steps in making a skybox. Now the skybox is a little miniature playset, I like to call it, that is outside the playing area of the map. And then what Source does is it takes that little skybox and then it scales it up. So you can have some small miniature set, and then it scales up, and that's like the skybox or the background of the map that you see behind the playing area. So if you see like mountains or buildings on the far background or trees or whatever, that's probably a part of the skybox. So what I'm doing right now is I'm making the base terrain. And as you see, that is a pretty big base terrain and not really a playset type of size. So, and that's because the way to properly make a skybox is to make it huge first, and then after you make it huge, then you scale it down because you want to make it huge so that you can actually make it match the existing terrain as best as possible. Okay, so I just skipped through the terrain making process because I'm not going to teach you guys how to do hammer. So I have all the terrain done, and I even did continue the rivers on the sides, and now I'm actually placing the actual sky camera entity in order to actually make the skybox. Because if you don't have a sky camera entity, you don't have a skybox. So I select sky camera, I select the terrain, I select all the water. Then I scale that down. Now this is when it actually becomes playset type size. I move it out of the map, and there we go, a little playset. Now I just change the texture scale so it'll look normal. Make some little changes to the terrain. I remove the detail sprites, although Hammer doesn't remove them, so it still looks normal in game. But Hammer is a bit glitchy and doesn't remove the detail sprites. So now what I'm doing now is I'm painting the skybox, trying to make it look pretty, adding some more terrain to it. I'm gonna add some hills and valleys, make it actually look really nice. And you'll see it at the end of this video. Okay, I got the hills in. Now I'm gonna start adding prop statics, which are our prop entities like trees and such. Or I can add the skybox first, and now I should start doing that. Prop static, there we go. Let's get a nice model. I think I do pine trees first. Yeah, pine trees. I put those in the far background. I rotate them here and there to really give them some randomness that nature has. Those are in the far distance. I believe I have to lower their elevation so they don't look like they're hovering. Yeah, it's a long process. But in the end, it's really worth it. So there I go. I'm shaping all the pine trees to the terrain. Then after I do that, I do some more different skybox props. So all these skybox models, all those pine trees, those are tiny, tiny models. But those two, like the terrain, are scaled up. So there I am, I'm placing all those deciduous models, copy, paste, lower into the ground, there we go. Really fast. And this is at 4x speed too, like the whole skybox making process, it's probably an hour and I cut a lot of stuff out. So there we go, I'm adding some more deciduous type trees. I'm putting those in the corners of the map, because I think those enemies might actually be a bit too big, but they still look nice. Alright, now I'm adding some more details, some dead trees. There aren't that many skybox entities, but the ones that we do have are pretty good. Alrighty, now I'm going to add some pine trees here and there, some lively 3D ones. And then after that, I place a few more deciduous trees as well. Now, and then in the end, all these props are going to look really nice, and they're going to have a fog, so you can pretty much see them from any distance, and it really separates the map from the older non-edited one. And now here I'm setting up the sky camera entity. I'm giving it the detail scale so it scales the little miniature playset properly, and then I give it the correct fog colors and fog settings. Have to keep going back and forth so I can get the actual values. And then once I'm done with that, I compile. And it looks quite nice in game. In the far distance, you can see the gray outline of the trees and all that. Yeah, that's a part of the skybox. So I hope you guys have enjoyed the video. This is just one part of a long development process. This is just one map out of many. I hope this video has inspired you to actually look forward to further BG2 content. I hope you guys have enjoyed the video. See you all later.